So about me, I am with VAHLE since nearly 36 years. I'm in the 36th year. Started 15 years ago purely with board segments as an application engineer at the beginning, right? At the first project. First project we had was very close to Germany. It was actually in Hong Kong. We were fighting for that, but we could even with new developments get this project. After that, I started as a key account manager, a market manager for the port industry, because it was necessary to be there from VAHLE purely for the port industry and for the customers. It was purely open doors. I mean, you have to see, since VAHLE was established, we were already in the steel and heavy industry, where also port belongs to. And when these containers, or at the beginning, all these boxes came to the port industry, then also somehow electrification of these newly cranes, not bulk cranes, container handling cranes, were needed. And since then, VAHLE was in this business. We were in this business with cable reels and with festoon systems, even with tenders, with cable tenders. That was a time when there was a difference started in the port industry to electrify self-driven container cranes, which are producing their own electricity with gensets. Means diesel-operated cranes creating their own electricity to drive the cranes. And 15 years ago, the idea was to electrify these cranes. Ideas were there, and that's where the one-man show starts. That's actually quite a developing story for the terminal industry. It's actually quite fast, because 15 years ago, 14 years ago, one of the biggest terminal operators asked us if we would have the idea, or if we would have something in our portfolio which we are using somewhere else, already thinking out of the box and inside the future. That means electrification, we were starting at that time. But they asked us if we could, at that time, to use our SMG, to which we had in our portfolio from the German aerospace industry for the Transrapid. At that time, it was developed from the Technical University in Braunschweig. And we implement that already 14 years ago for this terminal operator to demonstrate that with a forklift outside here at our facility and test track. And when we see it now, this is actually now state of the art. From the electrification of RTGs, we went to semi-automated RTG cranes. Means they were a jump from the electrification to the semi-automation of these cranes already with our data communication rail. In 15 years, also the port industry leads us to a further development. 15 years ago, we had 10 Mbit bandwidth. Now we are close to 600 Mbit bandwidth. So everything what the cranes are, or what the consumers need with their equipment, that one we develop further to use it now and to bring it to the full automation in a very short time. Semi-automation is already for the port industry a very big step. Automation will be a much further step. Now everybody is talking about artificial intelligence. So Looking at that, we know, or there are already autonomous trucks driving inside the terminals. So AI will be for sure helping the automation tremendously in all the terminals, but at the end there will be always a human being inside the terminal. You can say 15 years ago, everything started because it was not in the mind of any terminal to electrify their cranes forward. Everything was okay for them. But then when the fuel prices were raising, so they had some ideas. And we were actually the starting point for the industry to go to these, what they are now saying, 2030, 2035, up to 2050, zero emission. When we started to electrify, we were just the tip of the iceberg, call it, what would be necessary to get zero emission in total, or then sustainability on the long way, which is all necessary to do that. What is missing and what is coming now as the trend are all the trucks which are driving inside the terminals, all around the terminals, outside of the terminals, going inland, or what you can name it. You can even break it down to bring it to the trucks which were putting the fuel inside the cranes before. They were driving on diesel like every other car also. So now the trucks and all the movable equipment inside the terminals, they will be electrified, or they will be with battery capacitors, or however you call it. We as VAHLE, we will have electrification for RTGs. We will have dynamic charging of all the movable equipment. We will have shore power for all the vessels on the quay side during they have their downtime to handle all the containers shipped to shore and vice versa. So we will follow these zero emission and we will provide as much as possible equipment to get this goal achieved. Let's start at that time with Hong Kong. We start with Hong Kong modern terminals as one of the biggest single container terminals in Hong Kong. We electrified there 15 kilometers of conductor bars for 104. Now they are even buying more equipment, but 104 cranes in one go. One of the positive side effects came after a time of operating with our equipment or with our solutions, that they found out, and you can imagine, if an engine on an RTG is not working, nearly don't need fuel, it don't need oil, it don't need it needs less maintenance. Yearly, always upcoming failures were eliminated by using the electrification system, or I don't want to say our system, but this is one of the side effects what came with that. The next is that we would like even to use the same conductor bars out of our portfolio, which we already implemented, and I have to come back now to Hong Kong, because one of the first terminals who implement instead of a festoon system on a ship to shore crane, we installed a data communication SMG and the Unipol U35 on an SDS crane instead of a festoon system. And this crane was already old at that time and was still working after 15 years in operation. So operational cost with our equipment is an absolute positive side effect for all terminals. The next big one, DP World, is always in question and in communication with us to go. Even they are, Dubai Port World is one of the ones who actually everybody would think that they don't have any issue with the fuel, but all around the world, they need to have and they have to follow the goal of zero emission. Every day new are for sure other people, other person, personalities, challenges, all of that what maybe new generations bring to the industry, not only the import industry, to the normal life, other people around the world. That is something which impressed me day by day. Thanks a lot.